Good morning and welcome back to the Car Closet. And I came to give you words of encouragement and hope that will bless your lives and your children's lives. And the word for today I want to pull out is humble. 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 I'm trying to see if you can see it. I don't know if you guys can see it because it looks like it's, I can't see it from this angle. But humble. That's the word for today. Humble. And when we talk about being humble, humble is not being proud. It's the total opposite. And so many times when you think about humble, being humble is that you're bringing yourself, you're holding your peace. All right? You can hold your peace. That could be, the H could be for hold. You hold your peace. Even though sometimes you may want to retaliate in situations, or you may want to speak up, or sometimes it's for you to hold something and not to say anything. Sometimes, because there's a time and a place for everything. So when you humble, you're just humbling yourself. You're meek. You have a meek spirit. You know, you're not proud. Okay? Which would be the opposite of the word. So proud is like you're boasting of yourself and what you can do. And what you, it's all about you. But when we're talking about being humble, it's not all about us. As a matter of fact, it's not even about us. It's about Christ. And so when we're humble, there's no more me, 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 me. What I want. That's not being humble. See, when you humble, it's not a me thing. It's a we thing. And so let me pause here for a moment. Many relationships fall out because people are not humble. They're not humble because it's like, I'm just concerned about me, what I want, do this. And it's everything just about that person. So everything will be centered around that person. But when you're humble, you're giving to the others. Let's say a relationship, for example, you're looking to what the other person needs, how can I help you? How can I assist you? Or matter of fact, you don't even have to ask a question if you're talking about quote unquote relationship. You don't even have to ask the question. All you can do sometimes is just really look and see what the other person needs. And then you do, you know, whatever you can to try to help. And so when you talk about being humble, there's no, you're getting the big head. You being proud. You're not being proud. You know, and so most of the time we consider it like when someone says, oh, you did this or you did this, you say, oh, okay, well, praise God. You know, it's not like you looking for some type of vainglory or for somebody to come and pat you on the back and say, oh, you did this or you did that. No, it shouldn't be that you're glorying in yourself and in your abilities. It should be that you're giving the glory to God when you're being humble. And so when you're being humble, you know, like I said, you're not proud. You're not arrogant. You're not boasting yourself up, talking about what you can do, what I can do this, I can do this. Without God, we can do nothing. Without Him. So it's all about Him. It's about Jesus the Christ, because without Him, there is no us. Without Him, there is no church. Without Christ. And so we humble ourselves. Huh? When we look at examples of people in the Bible, anyone that was proud, let's look at Nebuchadnezzar, King Nebuchadnezzar, for example. God gave him the kingdom. Huh? He elevated him. This man had a lot. And then he gonna stand up and say to himself, look what he built up after he had the whole kingdom. And when those words came out of his mouth, he didn't even say, look at what God built up. Look at what God has allowed me to enter into. Thank you, Lord. I give you the glory. I give you the honor. I give you the praise. No, he stood up being boastful and proud in and of himself, saying, look at what he built up. Like he was the only one. You got all these people around you helping you to get you where you need to be. Huh? And so God just had to elevate him to that position. And so when God elevates you to a position, it's not for you to stand up and say, okay, this is what I do, or this is what I did, or now you abuse the position. It's not for you now to be humble and say, okay, God, you've given me this position. You've given me this position over these people. You've given me this position, whether it's supervisory position, you've given me ruler over this household or whatever it is that God elevates you to. It's not for us at that moment to now say, we gonna glory in it. That's not the glory in it. You give God the glory. And so what happened the moment Nebuchadnezzar did that, guess what? God took the kingdom from him. Now his hands became like claws. Why? Huh? Because he and his hair. They talked about his hair as well. The scripture said. And so coming, it's like he became into a bird. And so what happened? And he had to go through that for 7 years. Why? Because he did not give glory to God. He wasn't humble. He wasn't humble. And so humble, humble. That's our word for the day. Humble, humble. See, God resists the proud, but he give grace to the humble. And so when we humble, God will give us grace. That's, ain't that what the scripture said? He'll give us grace when we're humble. But when we proud and big ourselves up and we're proud and we arrogant in and of our own self, guess what? God will bring us low. God will sit you down. I'm a living witness. God will sit you down. He'll sit you right on down. And so when we're humble, when we're humble, we're thinking, we're looking at the affairs of others. How can we help? How can we help this one? How can we help that one? We're giving to others and we're looking at the affairs of others. So we're looking onto how we can help others and what is it that we can do. And a lot of times when you think about help, there's not always, help is not always monetary. But see, people think it is that you always have to do money, give money in terms of help. Now, God may lead you. You know, God may lead you. He do it to me all the time. God may lead you. Okay, bless this one with this amount. Bless that one with this amount. Do this for that one. Do this for that one. And he'll let you know what to do. You'll know there'll be a tugging in your spirit and there'll be some confirmation within you. And so he'll lead you to help others some kind of way. Okay, well, go help this one some kind of way. It could be anything. He may tell you, go cut somebody yard, an elderly person yard. They can't do it. He may tell you, you know, go do it or you pay for it to be done. So there's all type of ways of help, how we can go and we can assist. It could be just to go sit down and talk to somebody. It could be to counsel somebody. It can be, there's all type of ways of help. If we allow God to use us, see, if we humble ourselves and we allow God to use us as he wants to use us, not what we want to do, but what God is telling us to do. If we would just humble ourselves, huh? Humble ourselves. Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God and he will lift you up. Huh? That's two ways. One scripture says that he shall exalt you in due time. And the other one says, humble yourself under the mighty hand, under the hand of God and he shall lift you up. So the L in humble, we can go with lift, because guess what? God will lift you up. God will lift you up. And the same way God lifts up, we lift people up, God lifts us up. So we have to be humble. 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 When you get blessed, humble yourself. And let me pause here. Many times we're not humble because we think we deserve something. I think I said something right now. And so we think we deserve, I should deserve this. None of us really deserve anything. What we deserve is the penalty. Listen, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. That's what the scripture says. So none of us really deserve anything. We may yearn for these things. Those may be our heart's desire, but we don't really deserve anything. What we deserve is the penalty for sin. And we all have sin. There's none righteous. No, not one. I don't care who it is. Everybody, if you are a human being, we've all have sin. It didn't say you have sin. It didn't say only I have sin. It said for all. After all, there's nobody left. All is everybody included on planet Earth. For all have sinned and coming short of the glory of God. Huh? But God being merciful and just is not willing that any should perish, but that all sinners will come into repentance. So what did he do? He humbled himself. He humbled himself. Huh? And became obedient even unto the death of the cross. Come on. He's our example of being humble. Who could be more humble? If somebody beating you as you're going, he's being led. The picture in my mind, he's being led up to Calvary. They're beating him. Huh? punching him, hitting him, spitting on him, doing all these things, and he ain't opening his mouth, saying a word. He just carrying that cross. Carrying a cross because there was an assignment from God that he had to do. So he know, even though he wanted that cup to pass from him, Lord, if this cup, if it be your will, let this cup pass from me. But since it was the will of God for the sins of man, he took it on and he kept going. He humbled himself. Huh? He could have got back with them people right then if he wanted to. But he didn't. He humbled himself. Kept taking it. Kept taking it. It wasn't right, but he kept taking it. He humbled himself. Huh? And became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. That's why God gave him a name above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Huh? Of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth. And that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Why? Because he was humble. He was humble. So when he, by him being humble, what happened? God exalted him. God lifted him up because he was humble. So we're going to go forth in prayer. And I just want you all to be encouraged today. Sometimes you will hear people say, well, they had humble beginnings. When they're talking about humble beginnings, meaning that you didn't start out having everything. You didn't start out with the silver spoon in your mouth. Me neither. Most people didn't. They didn't start out that way. But as you continue to humble yourself and let God lead and guide you, he directs our path every day. And God provides. He provides for us. We just remain humble. Remain humble. Remain humble. I just want to stay right there. Just remain humble. Remain humble. Don't get proud. Don't get arrogant. Even when God bless you, don't get proud. You don't have to say, look at what I got. I got this. I got that. Listen, without us, without God, you would have nothing. Huh? If it had not been for the Lord who was, let us pray. If it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, we never would have made it. Now may Israel say, if it had not been for the Lord, when evil men rose up against us. Father God, we just give you praise, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for being our shepherd. We praise you, Lord God, that you're the keeper, Lord God. And we bless your name, Lord God, because you showed us the true example of how to be humble, Lord God. So Father God, we just pray right now in the name of Jesus that we would humble ourselves in your sight, Lord God. And we know that you would lift us up in due time, Lord God. Father, we pray, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that you will forgive us of our sins that we've committed, Lord, from the day we were born until this very second, Lord God. There are many times, Lord God, that we've not been humble. There are many times, Lord God, that we've been proud. There are many times, Lord God, that we've been on your hate list, Lord God. We've had a proud look, a lying tongue, Lord God. Feet that have been quick to mischief, Lord God. And so a discord amongst brethren, Lord. And we've been a false witness that bear lies, Lord God. So, Father God, we don't want to be on your hate list no more, Lord God. Father God, we just bind up anything that has caused us, Lord God, to not be humble, Lord God. And we pray right now in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that we would humble ourselves, Lord God, in your sight, Lord God. Father God, that we would humble ourselves, Lord, before you and before man, Lord God. That we would humble ourselves and do what you've called us to do. That we would humble ourselves and follow your mandate, Lord God, that you told us to do, Lord. That it would not be about we, Lord God. That it would be all about you, Lord. Following your word and your will and your walking in what you've called us to do, Lord God. And impacting the kingdom, Lord God. Impacting the kingdom, Father God, of darkness, Lord God. Stomping our head, our feet on the head of the enemy, Lord God, like you want us to, Lord God. Stepping on the enemy, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we bind up everything that's coming against us being humble, Lord. Right now, in the name of Jesus, we bind up anything that's coming against our families, Lord God, being humble, Lord God. And we pray, Father God, right now, in the name of Jesus, that we will continue to be humble, Lord. We will continue to be humble, bold soldiers, Lord, for you, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, that we would humble ourselves, Lord God, no matter the situation. We would humble ourselves even when folk are talking negative against whatever it is that you're doing in our lives, Lord. We will continue to humble ourselves, Lord God. We will humble ourselves, Lord God, even when we don't understand all the particulars, Lord God. But we will continue to humble ourselves. We will humble ourselves, Lord God, and continue looking unto you, the author and finisher of our faith, Lord. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, help us to humble ourselves, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Help us to follow your mandate, Lord God. What your scripture said, to let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, Father God, being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made of himself no reputation, and put on made up put on them the self form of a servant, Lord God. You became a servant, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. So we thank you, Lord God, that you became a servant, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, and you was made in the likeness of man, Lord. And being found in fashion as a man, you humble yourself, Lord God, and you became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore God had highly exalted you and given you a name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Because you were humble, and because you were humble, Lord God, we can be humble, Lord. Let us not make excuses, Lord God, that we can't be humble, Lord God. Help us to follow your mandate, to follow what you showed us, Lord God. Father God, that we will be humble, Lord, in every situation, that there be no vain glory, Lord God. Father God, there be no stripes, there be no murmurs, there be no backbiting, Lord God, that we would just humble ourselves, Lord God, that we would take on the form, the spirit of meekness, Lord God, and we will humble ourselves, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, and we will do what you've called us to do, Lord. Help us to not worry about who like it and who don't like it, Lord God, but follow what you said do, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Help us to humble ourselves, Lord God, in your mighty hand, Lord God, and you will lift us up in due time. Lord, we pray that we will be humble, Lord. Forgive us for the times that we've not been humble, Lord God. Forgive us, Father God, for the times we've been proud, and help us to be humble. Oh, Jesus, humble, humble. That even, Father God, even when we're on our jobs, Lord God, help us to be humble. Even when folk are coming at us sideways, Lord, help us to be humble, Lord God. We just pray right now, Lord God, that we would overlook some things. Help us to continue to pray more, Lord God. Help us to continue to seek your face more, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, and not looking to the left and not looking to the right, Lord God. Help us to be humble. Oh, Jesus, humble, humble. Amen. Amen, amen. So go forth and know, even when folk are, sometimes people are, they're doing things, they want to see your response. They want to see what your response, but the response that we're going to give, we're going to be humble. We're going to be humble. And so changes come in your life and changes in my life, because there was a time when I wasn't humble. When you come at me, I'm coming back. But this time and this new walk in my life, it's a new me. It's a new day and it's a new me. And I praise God for change, because it's time to be humble. Amen, amen, amen. Humble, humble. Don't matter what they do, I'm going to pray for you. Pray for you. Put that word on you and be humble. Humble. Your word for today is humble. Amen. Thank you all so much for continuing to comment, share, and like the videos. Thank you all so much. I hope that something was said that will bless your life and your children's life. And so your word for today, go forth and know that God is going to allow everything to happen in your life. See, whatever happened in your life is to get you to the place where God wants you to be. It's to get you to the place where God wants you to be. And so when you go forth and you humble, you may not like everything that's going on, but continue to remain humble, and God is going to work everything out for your good, because that's what he said he'd do, and he's going to do what he said he would do, but we need to remain humble. Amen. Be encouraged. It's my sincere prayer. Be blessed.